the first thing that Bangladesh is famous for is being a home to Cox's Bazar, which is actually the longest sea beach in the world.
Whoa, yeah, I've heard about this place before, but like, how long is it really?
It measures about 120 kilometers in length, actually.
Yeah, it's very long.
Yeah. So the beach actually gets a decent amount of visits from tourists from time to time. Cox's Bazar is also known by the name Panawa.
Okay, Panawa? Panawa wanna know what that means. Panawa? Cox's Bazar, what's the similarity there?
So it actually translates to yellow flower. You should know this. You talk about Bangladesh all the time.
Yeah, I know I should, shouldn't I? Okay.
So, speaking of large bodies of water, Bangladesh is actually also known for hosting the world's largest bay. The Bay of Bengal, which is located in the northeastern part of the Indian Ocean, is the largest bay in the world. It encompasses approximately 839,000 square miles and is bordered by India and Bangladesh. It's also home to millions of people with unique cultures that have been influenced by the wetlands.
Now, one thing to know about Bangladesh is that the waters aren't the only huge thing that this country is known for. Bangladesh actually has been recognized for being one of the most densely populated countries in the entire world. With almost 170 million Bengali people, it can be a very crowded place at times. Like, for example, the capital city of Dhaka. Oh my God. The current population actually sits at over 20 million people. It's a whole lot of people in one city. Now for this next one, I'm sure all of you sports fans are gonna know this, and just people in general. Like, Bangladesh is known for its cricket.
Crickets?
Yeah.
Like the insects? What are you talking about?
No, not like crickets. Like the actual sport cricket, you know, like the bat, the wickets, the bowler.
Oh yes, cricket. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. So Bangladesh cricket team, they made the World Cup in the year 1999, and they were granted a test status in the year 2000.
Oh, I knew that. Yeah, I was just about to tell them that.
I know you were.
Yeah.
I know.
Bangladesh actually has another record to its nature, the largest mangrove forest in the world. The Sundarbans National Forest is actually located in the middle of the river delta of the Ganges. During a multi-day trip on a hotel boat, you can actually discover the mysterious forest, and if you're lucky enough, you might just catch a glimpse of the famous Bengali tiger. So like I mentioned, Bangladesh is home to the Cox's Bazar, which actually has good waves all year round, and there's actually an active group of surfers in the area. Although the surf scene in Bangladesh is still a little young, it's definitely something that Bangladesh is recognized for.
And also, with so many residents on such a small piece of land, you can imagine that it can be very busy, especially in their capital city of Dhaka. So you'll notice that there's a lot of traffic that comes into the city, and actually it's pretty known for its traffic, to be honest. And one thing that's super crazy is that sometimes traffic, well, pretty much most days, traffic stops up to 7 hours a day, like just literally not moving, bumper to bumper. That would be annoying. But hey, that's just something that you really gotta embrace when you go to Bangladesh. Now, these objects right here, these are the bicycle rickshaws. They're still the most important means of transport in Bangladesh. The metal carriages are not only a convenient way to move around, but they also brighten up the busy cities. With thousands of competing rickshaws, you have to make sure that you stand out, right? And so the drivers have their carts decorated with the most beautiful pictures, and on the metal back plates, you can get a glimpse of rural scenes, Bollywood stars, birds, flowers, and elephants, all sorts of things. And sometimes images may contain political messages or painted advertisements. In any case, it gives you something to look forward to when you're stuck in traffic for hours.
So, Leroy, do you know how they say, like, an apple a day keeps the doctor away?
Yeah.
Well, in Bangladesh, it's actually a guava day keeps the doctor away.
Oh, yeah.
The southern region of Bangladesh is actually known for its guava production.
Yeah, that's very true. And also what I found out when I was, you know, researching this episode is that guavas are, like, actually known as the apples to the people of Bangladesh.
Yeah.
And, like, they have a floating market that sells mostly guavas, and Bangladesh is the 8th largest guava producer worldwide, with an annual production of about 45,000 tons.
That's a lot of guava.
Yes, I know. We know where we're going for some good guava.
Yes. So, the last fact for this episode, which is actually something that a lot of people find very surprising, is that Bangladesh is actually known to have one of the longest female-led governments. So, Sheikh Hasina has been the prime minister since 2009, and she was in office for 3 consecutive terms. And Hasina was not the first female president of Bangladesh. Khalida Zia was president between 1991 and 1996. Since independence in 1971, Bangladesh has been led by female leaders for 25 years. So, in the previous episode, I mentioned that Bangladesh is well known for its agriculture. But it's not only agriculture that it's known for. In fact, Bangladesh is well known for its textile work as well. Textile work of Bangladesh earns it a huge amount of money per year. The principal source of foreign exchange earnings in the country is the textile industry. After China, currently, Bangladesh is the second largest ready-made garment manufacturer. It is estimated that by the next 5 years, Bangladesh will become the largest ready-made garments manufacturer. Bangladesh is known to be home to one of the earliest urban archaeological sites, otherwise known as the Mahastangar, which actually dates all the way back to 3rd century BC. The village Mahastan of Bogra district contains the remains of an ancient city which was called Pundarnagara. It is believed that the location for the city in the area was decided upon because it is one of the highest areas in Bangladesh. Bangladesh is actually also known all over the world for the sages, philosophers, and the number of authors that come from this country. This includes literary giant poet Qazi Nazrul Islam, Sayyid Mujtaba Ali, thinker and social activist Muhammad Yunus, and Taslima Nasreen. So I mentioned in the first part of this series that Bangladesh is known to be a huge producer of guava, but the national fruit of Bangladesh is actually the jackfruit. Bangladesh is settled in regions of the four large rivers including Ganga, Brahmaputra, Meghna, and Wang. This accounts for the great agriculture found in the country, but sadly at the same time, this location is also prone to heavy monsoons which eventually lead to floods in the country, so the country is actually known to be home to a couple of floods. Bangladesh is known to host multiple festivals around the year, including Eid and Christmas, but it is also well known for its popular Pohila Boisakh, which is the national holiday celebrating the Bengali New Year. It is celebrated on April 14 as a national holiday in Bangladesh and on April 14 or 15 in the Indian states of West Bengal and Tripura. The day is marked with singing and fairs, and singers usually perform traditional songs welcoming the new year. People also enjoy classical jatra plays on this holiday, and people wear festive dresses, with women oftentimes decorating their hair with flowers. White-red collar combinations are particularly popular. Bangladesh is also known to host the world's largest delta, which is known as the Ganges Delta, known to be one of the most fertile regions in the world. The delta has the shape of a triangle and is considered to be an arc-shaped delta. It covers more than 105,000 kilometers squared, and although the delta lies mostly in Bangladesh and India, rivers from Bhutan, Tibet, India, and Nepal drain into it from the north. Between 125 and 143 million people live on the delta despite risks from floods. Talk about dedication. Bangladesh is known for its great tourist attractions, of course, and one of these attractions include the Curzon Hall. Not many people know that the fight to make Bengali an official language actually started in this stunning university hall that receives tourists from all over the world. In 1948, when Pakistan and Bangladesh were one country, the Constituent Assembly of Pakistan chose Urdu and English to be its official languages. This event occurred within the walls of this impressive Bangladesh university building and sparked the Bengali language movement, which advocated the use of Bengali as an official language. So Bangladesh is also famous for its Star Mosque, which is actually decorated with mosaics using an early form of recycling. When the Star Mosque in Dhaka was first built in the first half of the 19th century, the original Mughal design included a large dome in the center and two smaller ones on each side. The artisans who created these patterns used a technique called chinatikri and used pieces of broken bottles at times too, because colored ceramics were costly at the time. That's a whole lot of creativity there. So, the most surprising thing that Bangladesh is famous for is the Lal Bagh Fort. What is surprising about this fort is that the project was actually never completed. During the height of the Mughal Empire in 1677, Prince Muhammad Azam commissioned the construction of the Lal Bagh Fort, but the project was never completed. Three main sections of the fort are complete, namely the Musallam of Pari Bibi, Diwan-e-Ayam, and Quila Mosque. An intricate web of underground tunnels was also finished below Lal Bagh Fort. In an episode of the Sepoy Revolution in 1857, it is said that soldiers on both sides ventured into the tunnels and never came back, which allowed for rumors to circulate that the Lal Bagh Fort is actually haunted.